Hello everyone and welcome back to Jacklit Educational Channel. So this is the results time to announce for the Enviro Quiz Contest, which was conducted on 3rd of January 2022. So this Environmental Science Quiz is conducted every week on Monday on this platform to prepare ourselves for the Environmental Science entrances and to know something about our environment. So you can also join our Telegram group Learn for the Environment for the regular quizzes if you're preparing for any of the Environmental Science entrances and to improve your performance. So we will discuss the questions in the quiz contest and we will also reveal the name of the winners. So let's start today's video. So before discussing the questions, I would like to say that these are the rules for participating in this quiz contest. And yes, you can also win cash prizes if you become the top performer of the month. So you can see all these rules by pausing the video. So let's begin the question number one. So the first question was, the project Rehab is reducing elephant human attacks using which of the following? And here the correct option will be option number A. Yes, the project Rehab is actually using the bees to reduce the elephant human attacks, and we will know very briefly about this project. This is actually, the full form is, you should note down, reducing elephant human attacks using bees. Yes, this was launched in Nagarhol National Park of Karnataka, and this project aims to prevent the elephant human conflict within the range of elephant without creating harm to either of them. So this will not be causing harm to either elephant or humans. And here what happens is, it is a cost effective technique, and we'll also note that this project uses bees, as I said earlier, and this project using bees as a fence to prevent the elephants from entering the human habitation. So as a result, what happens is, the buzz of the bees irritates the elephants, and it also makes fear in the minds of elephants that the bees might sting them, and as a result the elephant avoid entering the human settlement. So Rehab is the project name, and the government is also planning to implement in other national parks in India. Let's move to the second question. So here is our second question. The second question was, the infrared bee has the wavelength range of how much nanometer? So here, before that, I would like to say there are three major categories or subdivision of infrared, that is infrared A, infrared B and infrared C. So the range of infrared A also, B also, C also, you should know. For the IRA, that is, the range is 750 nanometer to 1400 nanometer. So that is for infrared A. Similarly, for infrared B, which was asked in the question, the option correct will be option B, that is, the range is from 1400 to 3000 nanometer. And infrared C, that is IRC, the range is from 3000 nanometer to 1 millimeter. So you should note this, very important, IRC having the range of 3000 nanometer to 1 millimeter range in the wavelength. Let's move on to the third question. So the third question is on our screen. The question was from the solar pond concept. The question was, a solar pond is a pool of dash which collects and stores dash energy. So here, if you know the basic concept, we'll hit the correct option, that is option number C. It is a pool of, artificial pool actually, most of the time created by the humans, which is having the salt water, and it collects and stores the solar thermal energy. So this concept is very important, you should know about that. And here you should not get confused about blackish water. If here it would have been given brackish water, then you could have selected option B. So here option C will be the correct option. Let's move on to the next question, which came in the Enviro quiz. The next question was from the GIS, that is remote sensing and GIS, very important portion. Next thing was, which combination is not including a GIS component? So here it was mentioned not. So here you should know there are five important concepts in GIS concept, and the five important concepts are hardware, methods, software, people and data. So these all five are the important components of the GIS, and it was asking not. So all of them are the combination, so none of these will be the correct option, that is, none of these are not included in the GIS component. So these five things, the components are important. I hope you have noted down: hardware, methods, software, people and data. Coming to the final question, the fifth question was, when paper rots, it emits dash. which is a greenhouse gas, and when it is burned, that means when the paper is burned or composted, it releases which of the following gases? So here, this was also very easy question. Option A will be correct. That means when the paper rots, it emits methane, but when it is burned or composted, it releases carbon dioxide. And here you should also note down one of the very frequently asked questions, the global warming potential of these two gases. Carbon dioxide is the standard, which is having 1 as the global warming potential, and methane will be having the global warming potential of 25. So that is, I am talking about 100 year time horizon. Methane, that is CH4, will be 25 global warming potential, and carbon dioxide is the standard unit of global warming potential, which is considered as 1 as the value. So now it's time to reveal the results. So let's check out the results.
So 6 students have given 5 out of 5 questions correctly, and they are Ishan Khan, Khushbu Malik, Environmental Science, Alka Jain, Bhaskar Jyoti and Minhaj. So congratulations to all of you. And Akash Kumar, Gaurav Kumar and Environmentalist are just 1 mark behind all the top performers. So congratulations to you also. Keep up the good work. And if you like this concept of quiz, do subscribe the channel, hit the notification icon to get all further updates, and yes, participate more to get more opportunity to become the top performer of the month. Keep smiling, believe in yourself. See you guys in our next video.